This is the same little teapot that we have taken through the entire process. It's out of the bisque and it's ready for washing and waxing. So as the paraffin heats up, I'm going to wash it. Before I wash it, I'm gonna blow any dusters out of the spout. I like to have a sponge on a stick to really get in there and make sure all that dust is out of there. This is already dampened in the water. This is just a sponge. I like to use a upholstery sponge and just tie it on a stick with some fishing line. And I'm going to just take the dust off of that. You don't want to get it wet, you just want to brush the dust off and dust its little lid. Now the wax is almost ready, but I like to use glaze that's pretty thick. So if I have glaze that's thick inside the spout and glaze that's thick on the outside, chances are that strainer we made is going to fill full of glaze. And when the holes all fill full of glaze, it will be a no-drip teapot. However, that's not quite what we have in mind. I always have a little sponge, and the sponge is moist. And this is a regular caliper I use for measuring when I'm throwing pots. But now it's no longer a caliper. It's a sponge inserter and remover. I've got that in there because what I want to do is I want to paint wax resist in there. And so is it right in the holes? If the thick glaze in the spout runs down, it won't fill up the holes. I'm just going to put a little bit in the lid. I gave this a good shake before we start. Always give your wax resist a good shake. Shake it up, baby. And I'm just going to hold it in there and just with the tip of my brush put wax in every one of those little holes. It doesn't have to be that tidy. It doesn't matter that you don't have glaze in there. No one's looking in there. We made it all smooth. The clay is smooth and tidy. It just won't have a lot of glaze on it. Now I got a little bit of wax here. Did it just for your benefit. And wet wax resist, you can just wash it off. Now it's ready for drying, but this is the remover part. This is pretty cool. Just stick it in there after your sponge and grab a hold of it. Come on. Well, it usually comes out on the first pull. There it comes. And now I've got it just on the strainer. It didn't pour down. My wax is ready. I'm going to have a wax always again. Let it tip this way. Give it a bit of a spin. And now I have a perfectly straight wax line. I'm always really fussy with my wax lines. And now be careful when you're waxing your lid, because I'm going to fire this separately, is you have to not let it get too deep because it'll blurp up through this little hole and you have a big wax circle in there. Again, ask me how I know. I'm going to go to the edge, it's not quite level. And just get enough wax on there. You can see cover the bottom without it blurping up into that hole. Put it aside. Now the wax resist in here is going to take a while to dry. Watch the casserole demonstration to tell you how long it took me to figure out to chill and let wax resist dry. Anyway, so that when that is dry, we can go ahead and glaze that. The wax resist on your brush, you have to wash out right away. Like latex paint, if you wash it, it won't wreck your brush. So we'll come back in a minute when that is dry and I'll glaze the teapot. You know, my wax is dry. Well, my wax in the strainer was drying. I did get the rest of my waxing done and strainers painted. I've stirred this big bucket up. Now, I've always liked a big vat of glaze. I've never have liked messing around with little tiny buckets of glaze. I started working in a public studio when I was about 16, and I said, when I get my own studio, I'm getting great big garbage cans full of glaze. And that was years ago. And I've always had big garbage cans full of glaze. However, this is a big garbage can, but it only has about this much in the bottom. Okay, I've stirred it up with a big noisy thing, because it's a big noisy thing. And I just keep it stirring with a little stick. I like to stir the glaze a lot. It settles very quickly. You can glaze the pot this way, but as I mentioned, there's only about this much glaze in the bottom. And I'm not going to tip and middle mess around with it. Middle was fiddle and mess. I'm not going to mess around with it. I'm going to pour it in and pour it out, and then I'll decorate the outside with something after I've done that. And the next time I go on a chemical glaze or chemical clay run, I'll get some more chemicals and I'll fill this guy up. I'm going to stir that again because I'm talking and talking. Always stir between your glazing. Well, hardly even deep enough to dip the thing in. I'm going to rest it on there. I'm not going to ask that bisque handle to support the weight. And then I'm going to pour it out. And I'm going to blow the glaze out of the spout. That's why you have to make sure your wax is dry, because if not, then you'll blow the wax across with the glaze and it makes a mess in there. Again, ask me how I know. Now, I like my pots to be tidy. Everybody knows that. I don't like these dribbles down the side. I did wash the wax out of that when I washed my brush, and that's clean water. I've never tried washing with water that I washed wax resistant. I'm not sure why anybody would. So I just want to clean that off, making sure it's tidy. Give this a stir. And I'm going to tip this a bit. And when I put the, another thing I meant to mention, when I put the fancy foots on the bottom, or fancy or defined, see, now I've got a handle on this thing. I can turn this upside down in that bucket. I had to tilt the bucket, but make sure your teapot is level. And I'm going to glaze the handle. We don't want anybody hanging onto a handle that doesn't have glaze on it. And I'm going to let that dry. And I'm going to decide, I'll probably splash some colors on it, but you got this far, and now you can add another glaze. Some people like to leave it plain clay. I'm going to splash a few colors around and see what I get. Oh, I almost forgot to glaze this little lid. Just going to give it a stir. I like to leave that in there quite a while. Somehow it seems to adhere differently to the lid than it does the pot. And the last thing I'm going to do is put glaze on my face, is blow the glaze out of that little hole. Can just sit there and dry. When this is not so soft, I can add different colors to it. I'm going to get the rest of this stuff done today, and that will be a day.